A warm welcome, dear children. I welcome you back to the English Corner. I feel immense pleasure to welcome you again to the grammar part, right? Shall we? So, we saw grammar is important, why grammar is important, okay? All these are recap of the previous session, right? What is the role of grammar in a language, all that we saw. And I told you the clarity of the spoken language as well as the writing part will be there when the grammar is good. It avoids ambiguity. See, I told you to search the word ambiguity, and we gave an introduction to nouns, right? What is a noun? Noun is the name of a thing, person, object or feeling. All these we saw, right? So, next is types of nouns, proper noun, common noun, collective noun and abstract noun. So, these four are just a formal type of nouns. Again, when we go in deep, we add material noun also. Kinds of nouns is common, proper, collective, abstract and material noun. Again, when we are going in deep, so, we have 8 types: common noun, proper noun, countable noun, uncountable noun, concrete noun, abstract noun, compound noun and collective noun. All these we saw earlier. In proper noun is a special word that we use for a person. So, examples for proper noun, and it have, what is the rule? It has to start with the capital letter, right? And you saw that before proper noun, what should not be added? The article the should not be added before proper noun. This is very important. Why I am specifying and insisting you this point again and again is the major mistake that we are doing is this, the, okay, adding the before the names. The Bill Clinton is wrong. It's an absurd, right? Bill Clinton only is correct. Now, common noun is used to name general things, places, ideas, events, people, right? Common noun, the word itself specifies it is general. Example for these things, collective noun. Collective noun is a word for a group of specific items, people or animals. So, example of collective nouns. Then, abstract noun is a word which names something that you cannot see, you cannot hear, you cannot touch, you cannot smell, you cannot what? See, hear, touch, smell and taste. So, you cannot do that. Then what it is? It is a feeling. Okay. So, example, we have bravery, health and freedom. Right. Next is material noun. Material, the substance which things are made. Okay. This chair is made of wood. This ornament is made of gold, right? The spectacles made of plastics, plastic, not plastics, plastic. So, all these are example of material noun. Countable noun. Countable noun are those that refer to something that can be counted, right? Example, in our class, check how many students are there. Students are countable. Right? Any other example? Fantastic. How many pencils are there? All these are also countable. So, example for countable nouns we gave. Now, I ended here. Right? Uncountable. We have to go in deep about uncountable noun now. Uncountable nouns are the things that we cannot able to count, okay, unable to count it. For example, liquids, powder, gases, all these will come under uncountable. These are all examples only. Liquids in the sense, can you able to count in a full water bottle? How many waters are there? How many? The question itself, the question word itself is wrong. How many is used only for countable nouns? Uncountable nouns, we will ask how much. Okay? How much water? 1 liter of water only will say. We cannot able to count how many drops of water or whatever it is there in the liquid portion. Powder. See, you are using powder for your face morning. Okay? You just pour that powder. And can you able to count how many powders are there? That's what I told. How many is a wrong question word for uncountable. How much only is the correct question word. Gases in a cylinder. In a cylinder, you can see 14.5 kg weight only we can able to count. Gases we cannot able to count here. Can you say in this room, in this atmosphere, how much gases are present? We'll see. Can you able to see? Can you able to hear? Nothing. Okay? So you can able to feel gas and enjoy the breeze. Uncountable nouns. Bread, cereal, cheese, flour, jam, juice, meat, milk, rice, salt, soup, sugar. This is a sugar cube. We can able to count the sugar cube, but unable to count sugar. That is the difference. You can say that, ma'am, here 18 sugar cubes are there. Yes, I accept. Sugar cubes we can able to count, but not sugar. Tea, water, chocolate, butter, all these comes under uncountable nouns. Right? Any doubt? Yes. Very good. So when your mother is buying milk, or you are going to buy milk from a milkman, milk vendor, whatever it is, you will ask 1 liter of milk. Then what does that mean? Fantastic question. We are measuring the liters of 1 liter water bottle, 500 ml, all only the quantity. It's a capacity and quantity. It is not actually the drops of milk. Okay. Now, concrete noun. Wondering what a concrete noun is? Concrete. We will say concrete on the top of our building. But here, you experience concrete noun through 5 senses. We saw abstract noun that we can able to feel only, we cannot experience through 5 senses. Here in concrete noun, I am saying you, we can experience concrete noun through 5 senses. Right? Example, sight, smell, hearing, taste and touch. Any one sense is working also, it is okay, good. Okay, shall we see the example? Super. I love reading books. So what you are doing is seeing. Book is a concrete noun. You can able to see book. You can able to touch book. Then what? You can able to see, smell the book also. New books will come in a different smell. That is also okay. I am listening to music. Right? Hearing, sense of hearing. He is my best friend. So I can able to touch him. I can able to hear what my friend is saying. So touching. I am going to eat this ice cream. So taste. These flowers smell nice. Okay. These flowers smell nice. Smell. So when one sense is active also, we will call this as concrete noun. Can you able to understand, dear? What is a concrete noun and what is an abstract noun? What is the difference between these two? Right? Come on, tell me any two differences between concrete noun and abstract noun. Yes. Can be sensed through five senses. Which one? Concrete noun can be sensed. Good. And abstract noun, yes. You cannot sense through five senses. Right. Second one. What is it, dear? Yes, feeling and emotions. Feeling and emotions. Here, no feeling at all. Okay. Good. That is also accepted. Right? Any doubts in this concrete and abstract noun? Shall we move? Right. Next comes compound noun. See, compound, the word compound. What is mean by the word compound? More than one. Okay. So a compound noun is a noun that is made up of two or more words. Two or more nouns. Two or more words. In the sense, the word can be a noun plus noun also, a noun and a verb also, a noun and an adjective also, a noun and an adverb also. Okay. So, a compound noun is a noun that is made up of two or more words. Shall we see an example? Super. Lip plus stick equals lipstick. See, lip is a different word. Stick is a different. See the picture. Very beautifully it was depicted in this picture. Compound noun was beautifully depicted in this picture. Lip is different, entirely different. Stick is different. Totally what we will get is lipstick. That is also different. That is not at all related to this. It is related to lip, but actually it is a different object, right? Mail plus box. Mailbox. Box is a different word. When I say box alone, it is a different word, right? If I say mail alone, it is a different word. Together, it means mailbox. Fish is a different word. Bowl is a different word. When each and every noun was said independently, individually, it means totally different. Together, it was a fish bowl. Butter plus fly. Butterfly. Right? Butterfly. Basket plus ball. Basketball. Tooth plus brush. Toothbrush. So, what you observe from this dear? What information you got from this? Fantastic. When two different words combine, you are getting a new word which is totally different. See, butterfly. Butter is eating an eating object. Fly is there. We are getting a new thing called butterfly. Right? So, tooth is there and brush is there. This is also related to tooth which we will brush using. But butterfly is totally different. Right? So, compound noun is made up of two or more words. Don't think that they have to be related. Okay? They may be related or may not be related. So, children, I hope you understood the nouns properly. And if you have any doubts, we'll see in the next session, dear. It's time. Thank you.